Hello, this is Hiro of YouTube channel. In this video I will unbox and test for you the open source scan converter OSSC with multi-region PCU remote and overlay and GP21 adapter. All this bought for 142.90 euro without VAT. This is the original version of the device bought from Video Game Perfection in Dublin, Ireland. Inside I also have the Corel transcoder with multi-region PCU and the time-slate display lag tester. As you can see, everything is in big box, very well packaged, and it arrived by DHL. Box is 25 by 38 centimeters, almost 40. I can hear inside some cables and plastics. And you might wonder why I bought this device. As you can see around, I have many retro gaming consoles and computers. Here is an Xbox, PS2, Honey Pocket Game, PSP Go, Sega Mega Drive, Nintendo Famicom, PowerBook G4, Extreme One, Commodore 64, and many others. While I have the Decklink 4K Extreme 12G, which have the breakout cable with some analog receiving possibilities, unfortunately everything under 720 is interlaced, which makes it pretty bad for capturing video and computer game signals. It's good for camcorders, but not for this. Now let's open the box and see what's inside. It's fragile, so I have to be careful with opening. And here is the ultimate retro gaming video converter, the OCC or the OSSC scan converter with open source code. So many boxes. Very good packaging. Everything wrapped inside. This is the Corel for another unboxing. This is not sure what is it. Time slot display lag tester. Also for another video. Boxes, three white boxes, and anti-wrap. Wow, excellent SCART extension cable. What's this? Let's find out. It looks like this is the remote control. With overlay. This is the overlay. And setup guide in English. Chunk hop. Learning remote. And here is the most important device of them all and the most expensive, the open source scan converter OSSC. Open source scan converter. An anti-static back. There is small. Screw on the display. Here I have HDMI and audio ports, SCART and component on this side and VGA on this side, plus PCU port and some switch which says on off 5V. DC, V3 in, V2 in, AV in, RGB SCART, A1 out, A2 in, AV out, this is the HDMI, and A3 in. Additionally is the button 1 and button 2. They are easy to click, and JTAG connector on the bottom is the open source scan converter logo. For support visit videogameperfection.com. Model number, made in China. Date of manufacture, August 2020. Warranty void if label removed. Pretty cool looking, and this black design is very nice. And my fingerprints are not visible. Pretty good matte surface. Retro switch on and off. And the PCB is under the circuit board, which is open source, so no need to show it to you. Now let's see what's in the other boxes. This is the power supply with adapters for different countries. this is my adapter. I can use this as well, or even this with the converter that I have. This is PCU. It goes in the PCU port here. Easy to insert, and I will choose the adapter later. Let's see what's inside here as well. This is another adapter. This is for the Coreo transcoder and the JTAG, and another power adapter for the Coreo transcoder. Maybe it's this one, because it has some cable, or not sure, or it's for the times layout. Where is my JTAG adapter? JPEG-21 to SCART. It's this adapter which I ordered optionally. But how to insert it? This is JTAG. So I bought JPEG-21 adapter, but not JTAG. Okay. Now let's go test this excellent device. Here is my first test setup. The open source scan converter is connected to this HDMI bidirectional switch. With this rotating HDMI to HDMI connector, here on the left is my frame grabber Blackmagic DeckRing 4K, and on the right is directly to the BenQ 4K display. Let's turn it on for first time. It's off. I have to switch it on from here. It shows open source scan converter firmware 0.81A 2014-2018. And on the screen I have frame grabbed this test picture. Let's switch it off. On. It needs maybe 1 second to switch. Now I'll try to press some buttons. Nothing happens. No sync, since I didn't connect anything to it, but at least it's working. I have this test pattern. Let's show it to you on full screen. This is the default test pattern. with different shades of gray. 50 shades of gray. With the button, I'm switching the input. Let's try connecting some device to this. Here is my first test setup. PlayStation 1 gaming console with the game Gran Turismo connected with AV1 RGB, no sync. Let's turn it on. The red is no more flashing there. And it works immediately. This is interlaced signal here. And this converter is converting directly PAL to HDMI. When I select the HDMI input of the Blackmagic software, it says PAL. Just like what's written on the screen. Kilohertz, 50 Hertz, which is very good because the frame grabber captures it, but unfortunately it's interlaced. Let's turn on the game. Right now I cannot see any interlacing. Sony Computer Entertainment Europe. Wow. Here is switching modes. Gran Turismo. You see, when switching modes, it has some artifacts. For example, here the picture is moving. And on the screen I have 49.76 Hertz. Let's start the game. Memory card searching. Here the screen is captured, but I have interlaced because it's interlaced signal captured by the frame grabber, even if it's progressive. Let's try directly on the display. And it's interlaced signal. As you can see here on the BenQ TV set, I choose this game for a reason, because it uses high resolution interlaced modes. So this needs some tweaking for PlayStation playing. Let's see it again on the frame grabber. On the frame grabber I don't have such issues, which is pretty strange, but still it's interlaced. Maybe you see the pointer switching colors. Okay, let's try another console. My next test setup: PlayStation 2 gaming console PS2 with the game Gran Turismo 3 A-Spec. Right now no sync. Let's turn it on. The red is disappearing and it works. Let's switch to BenQ Direct Display. And I have pretty much the same interfacing. This is the default setup of the open source scan converter. You see interfacing. Let's start the Gran Turismo game. Here I don't have weather boxing, which is pretty good. Unlike on the PS1. PlayStation 2. The PlayStation 2 seems better suited for now. For the open source scan converter. English. As you can see, when playing full motion videos, even if it's interlaced, it doesn't have some artifacts because it's at 50 Hz. Let's see the game itself. Gran Turismo mode. Hertz conversion works very good. This Beetle is nice. Let's switch to the frame grabber. And here it's still interlaced. Let's try next console. My next test setup is this Xbox gaming console. Turn it on. It's connected with composite to SCART cable to the open source scan converter. It shows 4950 Hz, but unfortunately it doesn't work. You cannot cheat it with this composite to SCART converter. You have sound but no picture. So sound is going through the open source scan converter, but the video signal is not accepted through the composite. Let's try a computer now. Another machine for testing. This is Commodore Amiga 600. Commodore A600. Right now no sync. Let's switch it on. First without a floppy. And And it works, but unfortunately it's not exactly 50 Hz. It's 49.42. Which means when I switch, it works. 2.0 ohms. I have some artifacts on the picture, but this hopefully is fixable. Let's insert again. First to switch to see how it will look on the frame grabber. Unfortunately, on the frame grabber I capture the picture, but I have these artifacts. Moving picture. Let's switch back to the display and insert the game Paramax by Kingsoft. Wow, amazing picture, even if not crisp clear. There's some background noise. Very nice parallax. Amazing! If only I can find a way to remove this bars, or maybe they're from the video chip, but this is RGB signal, shall be pretty clear. Amazing smooth scrolling. Let's see on the frame grabber. And here is the picture on the frame grabber. Unfortunately, it's moving. Very hard to play, and there is interlacing. The frame grabber captures interlaced signal. Here is another test machine, this Commodore 64 that I adore computer, connected with this retro computer C64 to SCART cable that I reviewed before, and turning it on. 50.27 Hz. It doesn't work with the frame grabber. Let's see if the display, which is more forgiving of the signal. No. It doesn't work with Commodore 64 and SCART cable. Another test setup. Here is a PSP Go gaming console connected with component cable. The three components and audio here on the first. Let's switch it on. Right now it's not synced. I need to switch. And it works! Including sound. And here the signal is interlaced. 525E. So here I can use direct DeckLink connection, because it's pretty much interlaced signal in both cases. Now trying again, and I have the same letterboxing, same everything. So here I can use any other converter with the same result. The signal is interlaced. I have shown you in another video how I managed to fix the deinterlacing and the letterboxing. So my only way to fix this interlacing is to use the interlace filter in OBS. Let's switch the display. And this is directly to the TV. Very bad interlacing and letterboxing. So here OCCS needs more tweakings. Here is another testing setup. This is a PowerBook G4 computer which has S-Video out, and I am using S-Video to component cable. It's recognized, but unfortunately the picture is black and white and very interlaced. It shows 625 I. This needs to be deinterlaced. I can switch the resolution to 640 by 480. You see, it's still interlaced. 625E interlaced. With the use of S-Video to SCART cable, the results are even less overwhelming. I'm getting this only very dark red lines, almost not understanding what's happening on the screen. You see, and I cannot work this way. And here is another test of the device connected through this VGA cable to Micro Amiga One computer. Unfortunately, it doesn't work with the frame grabber in the selection of the beginning boot menu because it's at 70 Hz. 70.08 vertical, which is not supported by the frame grabber, but now in the workbench, which is default screen mode of VGA, it works. Now in workbench it's in full screen and there is no cropped image like on the other devices that I tested which convert VGA to HDMI signal. The refresh rate is vertically 60 Hz and it's 1125p. I can switch the screen modes, preferences, screen mode, including 320 by 256. Which is working and recognized as 528p. other resolutions work as well, including Full HD. And it's immediately switching on this display. Here is another test setup. This is an iMac G5 computer, which is connected to the open source scan converter with the use of this VGA cable with converter adapter mini VGA to VGA. And it works on the display BenQ directly, but as usual I have this issue with the max. It's never 60 Hz, it's 59.86, which means my frame grabber cannot grab it, even if I have plenty of screen modes, as you can see here. And even if I set the refresh rate, it's up to 120 Hz, which is not working immediately, but you see it on the display. It's not interlaced. It's nice. And I can frame grab only with the use of S-video cable on the PowerBook G4. Till now I didn't found any way to frame grab these Macintosh computers because of the unusual refresh rates which they provide. Let's test it on the frame grabber. No signal on the frame grabber. Black screen. ...620p. Some very strange modes. Even if I switch to 60 Hz. Cannot frame grab it in any of these modes. And something very strange happens here. Now let's set up the remote control and see if it will help in tweaking the device settings. It comes with setup guide in English. In Portugal and Spain languages as well. And it has lots of buttons. It uses AAA batteries. And this layout shall be visible to install. It goes like this. Okay, maybe I won't use this layout after all. It's hard to install. Why this is not self-adhesive? It will go like this. Here is the layout which I didn't manage to adhere because the self-adhesive part is not able to unwrap for some reason, but it shall stay like this. Oh, you know, the open source CAN converters look like a good devices for videography works with older computers and consoles. My first impression is quite overwhelming, but there is a lot of tweakings and settings need to be done. For example, right now it doesn't work with the remote control for some reason, even if I placed batteries inside. And additionally, I need to test it with this excellent device, the Corio Transcoder, for being able to frame grab other devices as well. And I will do much more tests with it, and much more videos will come of this device. Thanks for watching my video. See you in my next videos.